Well, it's one of the largest cycling events in the U.S., and once again, it's here in Colorado. The 2014 Pro Cycling Challenge kicks off Monday in Aspen. It's going to wrap up back here in Denver on the 24th. This morning, Ben Day from the United Healthcare Racing Team is going to join us, talk a little bit about the race. And you brought this nice toy with us. Take us for a little tour. Now, this is a bike you would use specifically for time trial racing, right?
Yeah, so this year in the USA Pro Challenge, we have the time trial up Vail Mountain Pass, which is it's sort of like a historical race that, you know, has a lot of precedent with Andy Hampston and, sure. and some of the US's great cyclists winning back in the day. So tell us,
these handlebars, obviously, are they built for time trialing?
Yeah, so this bike is built all for speed, and it's not really super comfortable. And we practice riding in a very special position that kind of improves our aerodynamics.
And this is for the iPad or TV, so you can
watch
something?
Yeah, so we can watch something and keep our motivation while we're out there. No, it's all pain at this point.
This is forearms to...
Yep. So we get down nice and low and try to tuck our heads in out of the wind.
Right.
And it's generally for an event that's between maybe 30 minutes to 50 minutes long. And it's not a bike that we're going to enjoy riding for 5 hours at a time. Let me just put it that way.
I can tell by your accent, you're from Australia, but you've lived in Boulder for a while now. Is Boulder still cycling Mecca?
Boulder's amazing. I traveled the world and landed in Boulder, and Boulder's home for me now, and so is Colorado, so I love it out here.
You're with the UHC team. Talk about team racing. I think people who've seen stage racing like the Tour de France, or maybe you remember the Coors Classic and remember how important the team concept is. Can you sum that up a bit for some of our viewers?
Yeah, it gets a little bit complicated out there. It's cycling is a sport where we have an individual winner, but you really can't do that without the help of your teammates. So mm-hmm. I was talking about that with my teammates last week, and that it would be a pretty difficult and lonely sport if it was just for our own sake, you know. But we get this great experience of really, you know, sacrificing ourselves for the purpose and sake of the team, and the success that we have out there together is something that we all share and something we all, you know, really enjoy. It's one of the beautiful parts of the sport.
Another beautiful part of the sport is in Colorado. You're talking about Aspen and Vail and Boulder and Denver. If you were a fan, where would you want to be watching the race?
All of those.
Be everywhere every day.
That's
follow
right.
along. Do you get many fans like that?
It's the USA Pro Challenge. The spectators that we have out here for this race, they're just amazing. They're some of the craziest spectators that we ever see, some of the outfits that we have out there, and they're having a great time, and we really respond to that. It kind of masks the pain a little bit for a few minutes, and we find different depths, you know, because of that. And it's a very enjoyable race, and it's not only us who live in the US who experience this, but we've got some of the best riders in the world
sure.
coming over from Europe, and they love it too.
You know? Well, we hope you guys have a great race, yourself, your team, and all the racers enjoy the race. I know we interrupted your training, so you can ride on out of here.
Better head out. All right.
He's been riding around the newsroom all morning trying to get his work in. Ben, thanks
Back
a million
up.
For coming by.
Have
a great race, and we'll see you on down the road, as we say in cycling.
Thank you.
He's off to the weather department or someplace. Again, the race starts next Monday in Aspen. So you can get out and check out the U.S. Pro Cycling Challenge.